Hi, this is Dave, and welcome to the Table, a series of videos where I review and discuss various board and card games, looking at them from a family perspective. Today, we're going to be taking a look at Tahiti by Minion Games. Tahiti is a 2-4 player tropical-themed pick-up and deliver game. In this game, you are the brave hunter who's sent out to explore the surrounding islands in search of food. When you find the food, you're to gather it up and bring it back to your village to feed the tribe. Let's take a look at this game and how it's played, and I'll come back and I'll give you my thoughts. Okay, so when we open up Tahiti, here's what we're gonna find inside. First, there's going to be four of these player boards, one for each color player. They're two-sided, it says Tahiti on the back. And this is going to be used up at the top. This is where we're going to store goods as we pick them up from the different islands. And then when we bring them back to the home village, they'll be stored down here. And this is kind of a score tracker at the bottom. Also, there's a nice reminder of the turn sequence for each turn. Next, we have four canoes, and they correspond to the colors of the player boards. Next, there's going to be seven of these favorite crop tiles. And they're, for example, this one here is bananas and coconuts. And you use this for a four-player game. There are some that would be used for a 2- or 3-player game, so you only use those for the number of players you have. And these particular tiles remind you of specific crops that you want to gather up, and they'll be worth more points at the end. Next, there is one two-sided start tile. And if you notice here, there's a monarch butterfly, and this is a different type of butterfly. And those will correspond to the number of players that you have as to how you're going to set up the board initially. There's a few water tiles where there's just nothing but water on there, and a regular large stack of island tiles that we'll be setting up and playing on the game. On the opposite side, just like a nice tiki looking guy. There is going to be this is the goddess Haumea. She's the goddess of fertility, and she's going to be used for a portion of the game, and she kind of moves around and she blesses the islands so that they produce goods. There is a stack of these tokens here. And this happens to be a fish, and there's ones with tikis on there, and these are depletion tokens, and they're used later on in the game to show when an island no longer produces goods. And I'll explain that more in the gameplay. There's a start player board, another turn sequence tile, and then the main portion of the game we're going to be using is there's 80 of these goods cubes. There's 16 each in the 5 different colors that they're going to use to represent the different types of goods, which are going to be bananas, coconuts, fish, taro, and spice. And then finally, we've got this nice little island-themed bag that all of those goods are going to be stored in. All right, let's take a look at how the game is set up and then a sample turn of how the game is played. Okay, so I've got the game set up for 3 players, and what I have done is I have set up the game board here according to the instruction manual. And the first 3 islands that are placed, I place the corresponding crops that they produce on the tiles. I've also placed the goddess pawn and the 3 canoes on the home island that's in the middle. What I've also done is I have taken all of the remaining tiles, shuffled them up, and placed them face up in 2 equal stacks off to the side. I have taken the 3 favorite crop tiles that are used in a 2-3 player game, and I have placed them off. They're going to be drawn in a second. And I have taken all of these depletion tokens and I have shuffled them around and I have placed them face down off to the side. And all of the crop cubes and the fish cubes are all inside this bag, and we'll shake them up and give them a good shake. So I am the first player and I will be playing the red canoe. And what I wanted to do is bring your attention to how this game board actually works. If you notice up at the top, there's a canoe here that has 5 white spaces. And each of those spaces represents the ability to carry a crop. Now, if you notice too, there are 4 circles that are on there, and those represent the number of actions that we can take on each turn. The more crops that we decide to hold into the boat, the less room there is for rowers, and so the less actions we'll be able to take each turn until we return to the home island and we drop them off. Once we bring the crops back, they're going to be unloaded and they'll be placed along the scoring track along the bottom here. Pay attention here in this one line here, which is +1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. You will gain additional points at the end for each complete set of crops that you are able to bring back. Also including the fish, which I will get to during the gameplay. At the start of the game, each player will draw one of these favorite crop tiles. This one here for my player says that my favorite crops are taro and banana. And all of these tiles will be kept hidden from the other players so they know what you're not going after. So I'll move these other two off to the side. At the beginning of the turn, there's four phases. The four phases are the exploration phase, the Haumea's bounty phase, the action phase, and depletion phase. During the exploration phase, you will move the goddess token. She needs to be able to be on an edge tile in order to place one. If she starts off her turn when she's already here, you don't have to move her. You can go ahead and place a tile, but then the next turn she's going to have to move because she's going to need to be near the edge. So for this demonstration, she can move one space. I will move her here. And then what I will be able to do is I will choose from one of the two stacks of tiles and be able to place one of them. So I think I'm going to grab this one right here that has banana and coconut. You can see here. And I will place it down this way here. I can place it next to this tile as long as it's touching on two edges, which it is right here. Now I want you to pay attention on these tiles to these lines that are on there, like right here and right here, and those represent reefs. You can move across the reefs without any penalty to movement. However, if you have any crops in your canoe, whenever you cross over them, for each number of reefs that you cross, you will draw one cube from the bag. If the cube matches the color of the crop that you have in your canoe, you will lose one of them. So if you have a whole boatload of taro and you pull out a green one, you will only lose one. Now, rules for storing these cubes, you can only have like one of each. If you have different kinds, you can only have one of each. However, if you have one particular crop, you can have as many as your boat holds. So now that I've placed this tile here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the Haumea's bounty phase, and when she's on the board, I will draw three cubes from the bag. And I have drawn a fish, a spice, and a banana. And I will go ahead and I will seed the island in spaces that are open. So right now, the only thing that I can do is I can place this banana right there. The rest of them go back in the bag. Now I'll move on to my action phase. On each turn, as long as my boat is empty or I have only two things in there, I can take up to four actions. So what I'm going to do is my first action, I'm going to move here. That is one action. Number two, I'm going to grab this banana and put it in my canoe. And I will also grab this spice and put it in my canoe here. Each time that I grab a crop, that is one action. So I have taken up three actions right now. And for my fourth action, I'm going to move back home to try and deliver those to my island. I have crossed two reefs. Therefore, I need to draw two cubes from the bag and see what I pull out. And I pulled out two coconuts. Therefore, I am safe when I move back. That's the end of my turn. Each of the other players are going to do the same action where they will move the pawn, they will place a tile, and so on and so forth. If we went around and we came back to my turn right here, I have two crops in my canoe right now, and so for one action I can unload. So what I would do is I would in turn take these two, I would take this banana and this spice, and move them down to their appropriate spaces along the scoring board. So this is going to continue on throughout the game. Let me explain to you the depletion phase, because that does not kick in until all the tiles have been placed. When the time comes for the last tile to be placed on the board, for example, if we move her here, we will place the last tile. At this time now, the goddess goes away for winter time. As soon as she leaves the game board, things change slightly. Now, when it's time for the bounty phase, since she is gone, we will only draw two tokens, or two cubes, from the bag. And we will seed the island accordingly. If you notice down here, on my turn, I'm going to start off here, and my first action is going to
grab this banana. Second action, we'll move here. Third action, grab this banana. And my fourth action will be to move there. Now we've come to what's called the depletion phase, which now takes place when Haumea leaves. And what we will do is at the end of the turn, we'll look around and see if there are any empty tiles, not including this home island. We'll look for any tiles that are not able to produce any, or that are empty from producing crops. And what I will do is I will draw one of these tokens that are on here. For example, I'll draw this one right here. And if you notice, there's like this totem on here. What I will do is I'm going to place this on one of those islands that no longer is able to, is empty and it will no longer be able to produce any goods. So I'm going to look for something that's kind of far away from where I need to be, one of my objectives. So I think I'm going to go and place it up here. So there's some strategy involved into the placement here. Now notice that this tile here, even though one of my favorite crops that I would like to collect is bananas, that's okay. There's still plenty of other spaces that are concentrated down here, so I'd rather lose that. And there are also some other tiles that the depletion tokens that will have a fish on here, and we'll be able to place those. And now I will go ahead and explain the other action that you can use, and that is fishing. Okay, let's talk about the fishing action for this portion of the game. And that's one of the actions that you can take. And if you notice on the island, if you look here, you don't see any of the white cubes which represent fish on any of these spaces. And that's because obviously you can't get fish on land. However, you can choose to go fishing on your turn. You can fish at any time as long as you're not on your home island. So you can use that as one of your actions, and you can try to fish as many times as your turn allows. There's two different options for fishing. Number one, before the goddess comes out, if you attempt to fish on your turn, you will draw two cubes from the bag. And obviously I did not catch a fish. If I chose to fish again, what I will do is I'll put these two cubes off to the side, I'll keep them out of the bag, and I will attempt to fish again. This time, I happen to draw two fish out of the bag. I can, even though I pulled two fish out, I can only keep one. And I would put that in my boat. And then I will not continue to fish on that turn because I have some other crops that are already in my boat. And the only difference now is during the depletion phase, if you were to fish on an island that has a fish token there, instead of drawing two cubes out at a time, you will draw three. So over the course of the game, you're going to be moving around to these different islands, trying to pick up various goods and bring them back to the home island and drop them off and collecting sets. This will continue until the depletion tokens are placed and there are only four islands left that will still be able to produce goods. That will trigger the end of the game turn. What will happen is that play will continue around until that round ends, and that will be the end of the game, and then you will go to final scoring. Again, what you will do here for final scoring is you will move along and look along the scoring track, and the first open cube, for example, if I had moved all the way up to here, if I had this many, my bananas would score 3 points because that is the first open square. Now, if you notice here on fish, you definitely want to try and catch some fish, otherwise it's going to subtract from you. Now, at the beginning of the game, we pulled one of these favorite crop tiles, and I wanted to explain that real quick as to how that scores, and that corresponds to this up here. For example, here I have taro and bananas. If I had collected the most bananas or taro out of any players, I would get an additional 5 points for each of those crops. If I had the second most, I would get 3 points. After that, I wouldn't get any bonus points. So there is an incentive to collecting those. The player who has the most points at the end of the game is the winner. So that's Tahiti. Let me tell you what I think about this game. I think that this game is perfect for families. This game is a lot of fun, and it can be enjoyed pretty much by everyone. There are several elements that make this game very much enjoyable to me, and I'll tell you what they are. First of all, the artwork. The artwork is cute, it's very bright, it's very colorful, it's very happy. I like the fish on the depletion tokens and the totem head,
and I like the little goddess pawn that she moves around. So the game just really gives it that whole island theme. Again, it's very bright, and I do like the fact that it's a tile laying game, so that there's some variation in the playing board every time that you play it. So I do like that. The game kind of changes itself up, and also the strategy that's involved in placing the tiles, how you orient those tiles with the reefs and where you place them, adds to the either the difficulty or a little bit of strategy as to how you're going to be able to make your route to go around and pick up your goods and bring them back to the home island. So I like those aspects of the game. What another aspect that I do like is the wanting to go and collect a complete set on your player board. You can gain points for getting a diversity of the crops and not just going after the ones that are on your favorite crop tile. If you go on your after just those, it's going to make for a very boring game because you're going to spend all of your actions trying to move just specifically to those islands. So while you're there, you should pick up some food and bring it back. I also like the risk-taking aspect that's thrown into the game with the reefs. You could take it safe and take longer turns trying to get back to the island without crossing over the reefs, or you can have a little bit of risk and jump over the reef, and maybe you'll lose a crop, maybe you won't. So that is one of the aspects that I do like. Also, I like the ability to manage your resources, and that's going to be how you're going to manage your turn. When it comes to the action phase, you only have four, you know, the most you have four actions. The more crops that you have in your canoe, the less actions that you are able to take. Now that's, you know, you may be moving slower, but you're also carrying more goods at one time to be able to bring back. So how you're going to manage that adds a little bit of flavor as to how you're going to play the game. Overall, I think that this game is very fun. It's very enjoyable. It's light in strategy. It's not very, very deep. So again, in a family setting, the game is perfect for that. From a family perspective, some of the aspects that this game offers is really the game kind of shows a practical application of responsibility and what it's like for having to go out and gather up the food and bring it back to the island to feed the village. And in real life, that's kind of like explaining to a kid or, you know, even a teenager why it's important to go out and have a job. You go out, you have a job, you gather up money so that you can go and buy food and bring it back and feed your family. It's not much different except here it's set on an island theme. So you have that bit of responsibility. The game also teaches you how to work with what you have. Sometimes during the game, when there's the bounty phase, you'll draw up cubes and there won't be anything that matches. It's like, well, what are you going to do? You're going to have to work with what you have. And then also the phase of the game where the depletion tokens start coming out, the resources become more and more scarce. So you really are going to be forced to work more with what you have. So I think that's a great practical application for your resource management. Overall, this game, I really, really enjoy it. I think that the game shines with how the game plays in terms of the length of play and the style of how it plays. Because you look at the beginning portion of the game when you have Haumea, the goddess, she's out there blessing the islands so that they can be productive. So as we're moving around exploring the various islands there and you're placing the tiles, we're going to be drawing those three cubes out of the bag, which is, you know, that's extra bounty. Well, then, of course, after the last tile is placed, it's kind of like the seasons change and she goes away for the winter. Well, now, at that point, you're only drawing two cubes from the bag. And so it's starting to make the resources a little bit more scarce. And then further on down in the game, as more and more of those depletion tokens start popping up, it makes it more and more difficult for your choices as to how you're going to move. Are you going to grab what you can get and then move, you know, bring it back to the island? And I also like the aspect of the fishing in the game too. That kind of adds an extra element. So you're not just moving around going to the islands, but you also have to think about, you know, not only there's vegetables, but what about like a meat protein? So that's the fish. And then I also like the you know, as resources on land are more and more scarce, well, then it's kind of like there's more of an incentive to go and fish in the water. So anyways, I like this game a lot. I've played it several times. I've played it with various different groups, and typically families are the ones that are going to really enjoy this. More of your hardcore gamers, they tolerate the game, but it's not something that they would go out of their way to play. The group that I played it with were more serious gamers, and they played it till the game was ended, but they really didn't have a whole lot of interest in playing the game again. So it's, I think, because of the variability and the shuffling up of the tiles, and then also the randomness of drawing the cubes from the bag does not appeal to their flavor. But I think in a family setting, this game is a lot of fun, and it really shines for that. So if you want to take your family on an expedition to Tahiti, check out this game and add it to your library. All right, that's it for now, and join me again next time as we take a look at another game and see how it can make it to the table.